right. Good morning.
Okay, first question. I need to ask you this. Comedian or comedian?
It doesn't matter.
It's one of those things that's like, because I always just say comic because it's easier.
Comic is comic. I don't mind either. Mm-hmm. I've been described.
It's gender neutral,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we're not in France, for God's sake. Anna.
You might notice a little accent. Karen, it's still there, isn't it?
It's still there.
How long have you actually lived in Maine?
I've lived in Maine 20 years.
Wow.
20 years I've been.
Do your kids have a little bit of the accent?
Oh, they got a half. So my husband's from Boston and I'm from Georgia.
Brother.
The kids are bilingual. Yeah. My oldest is learning how to drive right now. He's got his learner's permit. Hey, y'all, watch this. I'm fixing to pack the cat. You get a little bit of that. You know, it's mostly when they were learning how to talk, and I would hear them speak back to me. And evidently, I say can't, and I never knew it till my children learned to say, Mama, I can't see. It's wicked dark.
But that's fantastic.
Yeah, so, but if I talk to my mom, it gets a little bit thicker.
Oh, sure. You start talking with relatives. Karen Morgan will be at the Auburn Fireside Inn Friday, April 24th. Get all the ticket info right at our website, 92moose.fm. You'll find the post right up there. We'll get the link on our Facebook page as well. So you're from the Georgia area recently. Yep. Have you been down there recently to see the family?
I was down not too long ago. I went to my very first Civil War reenactment.
Wow.
And everyone should go.
Very cool.
It was very cool, but
I'd love to see one. I wouldn't want to take part in one.
Well, it's there's a lot of characters. They're very into their roles.
Oh, absolutely. It's their lives, right?
Since I'd never been to one, I was like very curious, and I wanted to. So these guys were setting up a cannon, and they had their Confederate uniforms all very, very detailed. And I just went over to this group of them, and I was like, "Hey, so how's it gonna go today?" And they were not happy with my question.
Get away from us.
They were like, "We don't win."
No matter how many times
we don't win. And then they wanted to say, but this is my friend Greg. He has a lot of fake blood. And when the battle starts, he's going to put all the blood all over himself. Oh. Greg dies real good.
Fabulous.
And then the guy says, I don't die so good anymore. It hurts my back to die hard. So I just ease myself down onto the ground, and then I die. Then there was another guy that came through on a horse wearing a blue uniform, and Greg got all red in the face and started just go to hell, Sherman! And I was like, you're going to have a real heart attack on the fake battlefield. You just need to let that go, Princess Elsa. You got to... And the funniest part was they were reenacting the skirmish before Sherman's March to the Sea. Okay. We were in Sandersville, Georgia, where my family lives. And at the end, they were going to have this thing where people talked, and they talked about the history, which is kind of cool. So when the battle was over, all the Confederate soldiers are just still laying down on the ground, and we had to walk over them. No one got
up.
They stayed on the ground.
Wow.
I'm like, yeah, y'all could get up, So anyway, that was my first
Civil War. Spent a lot of money for this blood. We're gonna use it.
Walk over me. And one guy was dead on the ground bleeding, and he got out his iPhone and he was like, video. You have to go to my Facebook. I have a picture of the battle, and then there's like a big dimsy dumpster trash can right in the middle of all the... it was hilarious. But it was fun. Everybody should go to reenactment.
To see all these soldiers with the Rolexes on.
Yeah, and but you're not...
They're pulling spring water next to them.
I was always... We were in Gettysburg doing a show one time, and there were like families that had the little kids. We know they were
all
like drummer
up.
Boys and whatever. Wow. I'm like, what if the kid just wants to play basketball? And the mother's like, no, you will be a fife and drum. No, Mom, not again. I don't want to do the fife. I want to play basketball.
Karen Morgan, you will see her live at the Auburn Fireside Inn a week from Friday night, April 24th. Now, you can get a discount, $2 off, too. And the link to get that at 92moose.fm, but you need a secret code, right?
Secret code, Karen, with a K.
Details, 92moose.fm. And you said a couple of other great comics will be there with you.
That'll be Stephanie Doyle and Adam Hatch, and we will have a great show. So everybody come out and enjoy the spring.
Fantastic. Yeah. Finally, some spring. Nice weather.
Yeah.
Now, you might see you down in the Old Port in Portland periodically, too, right?
Periodically at Captain Sam's Ice Cream. I'm the ice cream maker.
Fantastic.
So I just started making ice cream.
We talked about this the last time. Just getting things going into perfect ice cream weather now.
We opened on Friday, and yesterday was the day when everybody ran out of their house crazy. Go outside! time.
And you promised me some ice cream, and I was a little disappointed when you showed up without ice cream here, Karen.
If I come straight from my house, you get nothing. Just like my kids.
Get the link at 92moose.fm. All the show info for Friday night, a week from this Friday, April 24th, Auburn's Fireside Inn. And they're right off the Auburn exit of the Turnpike, too. Can't miss it. $2 discount code, Karen with a K. And all the details for that link right at 92moose.fm. Good to see you, Karen.
You too. Thank y'all for having me back.
I love your accent.
Thank you.